Hey guys, this is MATLAB Helper and we're doing a tutorial on transfer functions in MATLAB. Let me start by briefly defining for you what a transfer function actually is. It can be defined as the ratio of the Laplace transform of the output to the Laplace transform of the input with zero initial conditions. That is, I'm considering my system to be initially relaxed. Now, the reason why transfer function as a concept is so important is because it gives me a direct relationship between my output and input, which is used in so many control algorithms and applications. Now, the reason that I am using the Laplace transform is because the control systems have several different kinds of physical quantities, and in order to bring them to the same platform, we make use of the mathematical tool that is the Laplace transform. Now, in MATLAB, we have a very special function called TF, which is used to define and create transfer functions. Now, the basic syntax of creating a transfer function object, suppose sys, is equal to TF, and in the parentheses, we enclose the numerator and the denominator. Now, the numerator and denominator here are actually coefficient matrices of the transfer function polynomial. Now, what I do is I input my numerator. Suppose I want my transfer function to be s plus 1 divided by s squared plus 2s plus 3. So I'd be inputting the coefficients in the square bracket, say 1, 1. And then I'd be inputting the coefficients for the denominator in the square brackets, which would be 1, 2, and 3. Now, these are the coefficients in the decreasing order of s. Keep that in mind. Now I'd be entering and let's see what the output looks like. So as you can see that MATLAB has created for me my desired transfer function. Over here you can see it's written continuous time transfer function, which means that by default the TF function creates a continuous transfer function in the S domain, which is the continuous domain. We can also create transfer functions in the discrete domain, but the transfer function variable that I'd be using over there would be z. Now, another method to create a transfer function is by first defining my variable s and then writing my transfer functions. So that would be better clear by an example. Now I'd be writing, say, s as my variable. S is equal to tf, and in the parentheses I'd enclose in single quotes s. Now I've written the letter s here. You can use any letter you like. You can use a, b, c, d, e, whatever you like. I'd be following the statement by a semicolon. What the semicolon does is it does not let me view the output in the very next line. It prevents my output from showing up. Now suppose I define a transfer function sys is equal to s plus 1 divided by s square plus 2s plus 4. Now this is similar to the previous transfer function except a slight change in the denominator. Now I've gotten a similar transfer function as in the previous case, and I did this using a different method. Now what we were doing over here was what we were creating transfer functions for single input and single output control systems. That is, I only have one input and one output. I can also create transfer functions for multiple input and multiple output control systems. That is, I'd be inputting my various numerators, that is my various inputs, my various outputs, and then creating the corresponding transfer function. So let me start by inputting my numerator. So suppose I have two inputs, so I'd be inputting them as within the square brackets. Now the entire numerator is enclosed in curly brackets, that is my multiple inputs, and I'd be separating those inputs by semicolons. So I've inputted my first one as 1, 2, 1. I enter a semicolon and I enter the next one, which is 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 1. Now similarly, I'd be inputting my denominator. Let's keep the denominator very simple. Let me take it as 1, 2, 3. Now this is a 2-input, 1-output system. So now I'd be creating my transfer function object, which would be TF, and in the parentheses I'd write N, D. Now as you can see, I've received 4 transfer functions here. Now, how the multiple input, multiple output system actually works is that at one time, only one input is active and the remaining ones are zero. So for that one particular input, I get a particular output and then I create a transfer function. So when we have multiple inputs and multiple outputs, there are several combinations that are possible. So we get several transfer functions. By default, MATLAB outputs all the transfer functions. It can, however, also output transfer functions corresponding to a particular input or a particular output. Now I'm defining another simple transfer function object, say sys. In case you forget the syntax, it always has hints showing up. Now I can manipulate this transfer function using a new variable. So suppose I have sys1 and I can write that as 4 times of sys. Say 3 times of sys. So now as you can see, I've gotten a new transfer function, which is a manipulated version of the first transfer function. So this is another way of using transfer functions. Now I can also view my transfer function graphically, and I have several plots in MATLAB. One such plot is the step plot. So I'd be writing step plot enclosed by my transfer function object in the parentheses. So you can see that MATLAB has plotted for me the step response. Now what it does, it takes the step input, a step signal as the input, and a given transfer function that I've entered in the parentheses, what would the output look like? Something of this sort. So this is called the step response. Now this was the basics of how to construct a transfer function at MATLAB. If you have any questions or queries, you can leave them in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to MATLAB Helper. Go check out our Facebook page and keep checking out MATLAB Helper for more such videos. Thank you.